No, that's not it. Why did the dog buy a bunch of shingles?
I don't know. Why would a dog buy a bunch of shingles?
Because it wanted to be a woofer.
Oh. I see. Okay.
So I have another joke for you.
Oh, good, good. Let's hear another one.
Okay. What do you get if you cross a lion and a dog?
I don't know. What do you get if you cross a lion with a dog?
Well, I'm not sure either, but I bet your mailman won't stop at your house.
Major problem. problem with the miners?
And hey, when the military comes through, though it's not very often anymore, the officers leave the rooms a mess.
Big.
So, there's a minor problem with the majors?
Without the miners buying pets or staying in the hotel, the 9-to-5 pet store and hotel has been in the doghouse. We don't have enough money to pay the mortgage, and now you're saying that Grandma Nan and I are destined to roam the streets with all our beloved animals. Oh, son!
Miss Knight, it's my legal duty.
Oh, Hugh, what do we do? We're in quite a stew. Oh, boo-hoo!
Wait, please reconsider. I'll pay the mortgage.
And just how are you going to make that happen, pray tell?
I'll give you the most valuable thing I have.
And just what do you have?
My word.
Well, your word is worth a lot. But not enough to keep my depositors happy.
Okay, how about all the money I've been saving up to buy my own ranch?
And how much is that?
$7.
Not enough.
Okay, how about my word, $7, and my shotgun?
Okay. I'm sorry, Miss Nine, that's still not enough. I'll be back later with the official papers.
This is horrible!
Don't worry, Polly. Don't sweat, Miss Knight. I'll figure something out. There's a solution to every problem.
There must be something we could do.
I'm sorry, Polly, but I think all we can do right now is to just keep on keeping on and hope for some better business soon.
Yeah.
In the meantime, I've got hundreds of animals to feed. Why don't you come over here and sit down? I want you to think positive thoughts while I'm gone, and I'll be back as quick as I can.
Okay?
Hello, Miss Polly.
Oh, well, hello, Barbara.
I finally have what you've been asking for.
Barbara Black Sheep, have you any wool?
Yes, ma'am. 3 bags full.
Oh, it's just what we've been needing. Many of the animals are getting goosebumps at night, especially the geese. But we work hard to make sure the animals are as nice and comfortable as our valued hotel guests. Well, when we have any. Oh, well, hello, Liza.
Hello, Miss Purina.
Oh, it's so wonderful to see my favorite girl. What can I help you with?
Rover, my rare Tasmanian man-eating gerbil. Well, as you can see,
Wait, that's it! Gerbils like bananas, too!
Really?
Oh, come here, Liza. Don't worry, I'll do the peeling for Rover. How many should I take, Miss Purina?
Just one banana should make Rover happy.
Oh, thank you, but... Oh, dear, how much money do I owe you? I only have the one penny!
Don't worry, little Liza. Let it be a gift from me to you.
Really? Oh, really? Thank you, Miss Purina, thank you!
Well, now you run along now and give Rover a nice meal filled with potassium.
That was awful nice of you, Miss Polly.
Oh, how could I take a penny from that precious child? And you know, those rare Tasmanian man-eating gerbils need food all the time.
Yes.
Are you and your grandma keeping the hotel's 5 rooms filled to capacity?
Oh, not at all. What can we do?
Well, you could have a bird contest.
Oh.
With no purchase necessary.
I don't know.
Or you might buy some of my sheep to entertain your guests.
Oh.
They play tubas and are really hilarious.
Oh, I don't know about that either. You know what they say. A sheep owner who sells their flock for too little might get fleeced. It's a terrible thing.
It is. It's a terrible thing. Yes.
Well, that the sheep owner gets fleeced, of course. But, I mean, I guess things aren't all bad, but...
No, they might not be as bad as they seem.
Well, you know... Me and my grandma might be affected.
You may get lost.
64.
And it might rain muddy.
Barbara Black Sheep, there's no change in the weather.
Oh. Hey, Barbara. Hey, Polly.
Oh, hello, Cattle Kate. Oh, dear. You were sure walking funny.
Oh, I've been branded. I got sore calves. Well, this ain't branding season.
Yeah.
Well, I know. I just want all my cattle to have the appropriate identification. Because I'm getting ready to move on.
Moving on?
Yeah, that's right.
But why are you leaving?
Well, it just seemed like the right time. I've been working real hard and nothing's working out for me. So it's time to move on.
Oh, please don't leave.
Yeah. We'll have a cow if you leave.
That's not true. If Cattle Kate leaves, we won't have a single cow. Not one.
Oh, hey, do you girls know why cows have hooves instead of feet?
No. Why do cows have hooves instead of feet?
Because they lack toes.
Oh, oh, please don't leave, please.
Oh, Polly, mooch is grasses for all your friendship. We'll miss you. Will you ever come back?
Will you?
Well, I doubt it. I'll always remember this town. I gotta go. I just hate goodbyes like this. So long, Polly. So long, Barbara.
Going through Alphaville. That means no miners, no tourists.
Not really.
Oh, well, thank you. It's not ladylike for a heroine to be negative, you know. It's really not that bad. Much better.
How are you, ending up with all them abandoned animals?
From You Can Do It! That handsome humanitarian whom, I must admit, I have fallen for. Oh, sigh. Oh, he cares for those precious creatures of nature as much as I do.
Well, I'm surprised You Can Do It is still in town.
Well, he originally came to find gold in the creek like everyone else, but when there was no gold left to find, he thought about leaving, but he has fallen in love with the land. He's so handsome, he wants to become a farmer. He's working hard to earn the money and buy his own land. And he's so strong, he wants to build a house and make a special home for all wayward animals. And he's so kind. Did I mention handsome?
Very handsome.
Oh, so handsome. Oh, every day he comes in with another abandoned animal and asks us to take care of it until we can buy the land.
Hmm. Wouldn't some people call him a dog catcher?
Well, I call him an eye catcher. He's much more than a dog catcher could ever be. He cares about all animals, from the hurt hog to the deserted duck. He cares for them all.
Well, that must be why. That must be why things must be getting so tough around here.
Yeah.
You must be taking care of more animals than guests. Doesn't that get expensive?
Oh, it does. We're down to our last few pennies just feeding the animals.
Well, why don't you tell Hugh that you can't take any more?
Well, we care for our little friends. And I care about my big friend. But tragedy has struck.
Oh, what could be a bigger tragedy than losing your mortgage and being down to your last few pennies?
Many of our animals are getting fleas.
My sheep have a lot of fleas too.
Oh, no! I mean the little bug that causes those animals to suffer from that atrocious itching like you are now.
What?
Oh, no, you don't have fleas, don't worry. But in time, they may all go insane.
Oh, is there anything that can be done?
Oh, if only we had a veterinarian in town, but why would a qualified animal doctor ever come to a town that's dying? There I go being negative again. Please forgive me.
Okay.
Hello, Grandma.
Hello, Polly, dear. Have you been crying again, kitten?
It's okay, Grandma. I'll always be strong for you. Just like how Grandpa Asinine was before he passed on.
And what bring you here, Barbara?
Well, I'm just dropping by some of the wool you ordered.
Oh, yeah, the wool. How much do we owe you for that?
30 cents.
30 cents?
Thanks.
Well, I hate to tell you this, Barbara, but we just can't afford that wool right now. We got too many pets and not enough customers.
Yeah.
I just got to send you back home with it. I'm so sorry.
Well, that's okay, Kay.
Really?
Yeah. I'll just put it on your tab. I know you'll pay me soon. You folks have never done me wrong before.
That's true. why we can't keep her. We could just feed her scraps, you know.
Yeah.
And we could really use a happy critter around here right now to cheer us up.
Yeah.
Until we lose our home, that is.
Oh, thank you, Grandma. No, I don't want her to get any of those evil fleas in her paws. You know what would happen?
No, what would happen?
She'd suffer the agony of defeat.
Well, ladies, I guess I better be getting back to work. I'll just take these sacks of wool and give fresh bedding to all the rest of our little animals. Thanks again, Barbara. All right, gang.
Well, I guess I better mosey on back to my work as well. It's shearing time.
Oh.
And it gives me a sheep real feet.
Will you look at this beautiful puppy? Who can doubt that she's the true symbol of hope for the 9-to-5 pet store and hotel? When I look into your eyes, I see a beautiful kaleidoscope of breeds. You are as delicate as a poodle, as fast as a greyhound, and like a St. Bernard in a raging snowstorm. You would risk your life to save my soul.
Really?
What sort of Mr. Bees.
Now may be my chance to impress this animal lover. I am a doctor.
Oh.
A veterinarian, in fact.
Oh.
And Miss Litter here is my capable nurse. Hoping for hers, not yours. I've undoubtedly won her over with my supposed compassionate profession, along with my strength. My good looks.
Case.
lawyers never die. They just lose their appeal.
Okay, I got it. Lawyers always win lawsuits. Okay, I know. Enough about lawyers. It's time to get over it, Frank.
You're right. But it'll take making lots of money! Not only to get back the money I paid to that vet school without even graduating, but also to compensate me for the money I lost in the cow suit. I can't face your grandma or any other animals.
Quick, let's just get out of here.
Oh, all right, but I'm too tired to go far. I'm too struck with that sweet, charming, compassionate, naive, and even friendly girl!
Together.
Yes.
Oh, and you are?
I'd agree.
And
and I'm Patty Gree.
And this is Browser,
the amazing Schnauzer.
And we, of course, are the Gree sisters.
Ta-da!
Very interesting. Well, I'm pretty sure I can find a room for you all. And I can find a flea-less space in our pet store for Rounder so that she won't get those fleas.
Oh, no! You are looking at a priceless dog.
She never leaves our side.
No.
Oh, and what makes her so precious?
We have trained her for years to be part of our act.
Yes. She does some amazing tricks.
Really?
Yes.
Well, let's see what they are. I'd love to see them.
See, she falls.
Okay. Watch. Browser, roll over.
Browser, jump.
Browser, do a double axle triple flip with a 1.5 triple somersault.
Oh no! Could this be more serious than we thought?
Well, I'm sure things will get better, ladies. You know, I once knew a pig that could do karate.
Really?
Yeah, she had a mean pork chop. Hi-ya! Anyways, why don't you ladies sign into this register? And I'm going to put you all into room one.
Oh, thank you.
There you go.
One step at a time, Miss Harmony. You're going to be fine. Now, Miss Harmony, we just need to get you a room, and you'll be fit as a fiddle after you rest just a little bit.
That hideous thing makes me sneeze and itch. Oh, and it gets in hair all over my hat. Oh, why did I have to travel with these wacky ladies and that atrocious beast.
We were wondering the same thing about you.
How dare you say such a thing? Don't you know you are speaking to Miss Harmony, noted opera singer and hat connoisseur?
Well, we wish you would sing solo.
Solo, we couldn't hear you. Or tenor.
10 or 12 miles from here.
You obviously don't know true art. Watch out! Jake looks good with the rest of his Western attire.
Don't worry, I have everything under control. Though my heart beats out of control while I'm near the kind, gracious, beautiful Polly.
Oh, how could I be afraid when you're here, Hugh?
Thank you, Polly.
You're welcome, Hugh.
You're mighty kind.
Oh, thank you, Hugh. You know, I appreciate the compliment. Oh. And I appreciate his existence and how handsome he is.
Words are so sweet. As sweet as her lips must be.
Well, thank you, Hugh.
You're welcome.
That's enough, Dad. I think that you two already know each other.
Of course we do. Folks, I'd like you to meet Hugh Can Do It.
Howdy, Hugh. Howdy.
He's a cowpoke and an animal rights advocate.
Howdy, y'all. Don't be alarmed by this little snake.
Oh. We just want to be sure that
Rouser is safe.
Rouser? The amazing Schnauzer?
Don't worry. I just came by to drop this fellow off. I found him slithering around the caves out back. He was so lost and disgruntled. He must have been a pet to one of the miners who left town. Oh, you sure did dirty. Probably slithering aimlessly around. Pretty slimy, mighty. Oh, poor little guy.
He's so lucky to have you. You're so brave, Hugh.
Shucks, Polly. It's nothing nobody would have done for an anaconda.
Anaconda?
I guess some people like interesting pets.
It's okay, Hugh. Just bring him on over here and set him on the couch.
Yeah.
I'll fix him up a nice warm bath. And a cozy spot in the back.
You're just going to leave him there?
That doesn't seem real safe for Rouser.
Yeah, I think we should take a walk.
Yeah, let's go take her for a walk.
Get away from the snake.
Yeah.
You never have liked snakes.
They're icky!
Don't worry. I had a talk with him before we came in. I told him he better behave himself or I tie his neck up in a knot and stick him in the corner. Hear me out. It may seem harsh, but some snakes need more house training than others.
Well, no amount of house training would be enough for me.
It's okay, Hugh. It's the thought that counts.
Catch.
Miss Kitty.
How do, Miss Harmony?
I'm doing all right, I suppose. How are you?
Oh, I'm feeling a little catty today, but other than that, I'm doing pretty good.
Don't you always?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, anyhow, I had a joke for you.
Okay, lay it on me.
Why are snakes so hard to trick?
I don't know. Why are snakes so hard to trick?
Because you can't pull their leg.
Get the money to pay the mortgage.
But what are you doing for Farmer McDonald?
I'm just setting up a new place for his pigs.
Oh, you know, I heard some of his pigs lost their voices, and they were becoming disgruntled.
I hate to admit it, but some pigs can be impolite.
Do some even tattletale?
Yep, some can be real squealers. But the most important thing is that these animals are finding a new home. And if any animal, big or small, needs a hand, my hand will be there. Lick or scratch. Good day, dear Polly.
I'll miss you, Hugh. I'll miss you.
You who to you too.
Come down to earth here, Polly. Oh. You know, sometimes I think that Hugh really likes you.
Oh, well, you know, I wouldn't say that.
And I think you like Hugh, too. That's a tongue twister. Oh, you too.
Well, Grandma, don't make me blush. We're just good friends.
Sure.
Right now.
I need a room, too.
Well, I'm sure we can fix your item. Let's see, let's put you in room 3. Where's the key? Now, where can that be?
Oh, darn it! I gave the room to her!
Who?
Grandma! I told you! Darn it!
Wow! I'm more upset about this situation than I realized. You know, she has never spoken to me like that before. Can you see me over her arm? I'm speaking in the dark here. Anyways, she has never spoken to me like that before, and so you know what? I'm just going to have to pull her aside and talk to her when there aren't so many people around. Well, I'm sorry. Let's see if they have some other rooms here. How about room 4 or 5?
I'm sorry, but I gave rooms 4 and 5 to Dr. Ray Bees and his capable assistant, Nurse Kitty Litter.
Were they upstairs?
No, but they'll be back soon.
Okay. Well, what about room 3? Who is in room 3?
Darn it! I think you like her.
Okay, you don't have to snap at me. I'll take it. I'm so desperate that I'll share the room with her, whoever she is, and tell her I'll pay the entire bill if she gives me the bed and total use of the mirror.
Don't worry, she likes to sleep on the floor in a box.
In a box?
In a box?
In a box?
That can't be comfortable.
Don't worry. I give her something to chew on.
Chew on?
Chew on?
Chew on?
Just sign the ledger, please. There. And here's the key to room 3.
Well, why do you have the key?
Darn it! She had it in her mouth, but kept on dropping it.
This girl sounds awfully strange.
Darn it! She's a dog!
Oh, I don't care what she looks like. Just as long as she's warm and friendly.
Don't worry, she's certainly that.
Mr. Horse.
Yes, Miss Harmony.
Please bring my hat boxes up to my room.
Okay, I'll be happy to go empty the stagecoach out in just a minute, but first, I need to go take a walk. Oh, I feel like Charlie Horse coming on. That's the best you got? Hey, buddy, come on! Hey, that hurt.
Let's go to our room.
Yeah. Come on, Rouser. Come to Patty.
Oh, this is horrible. This is worse than we thought.
She always comes when she's called.
Oh,
this doggie needs help.
She does. Is there a veterinarian in this town?
Oh, I'm sorry, ladies. I wish that there were.
Grandma, that's why I wanted you to meet Dr. Ray Bees. He's no ordinary doctor. He's a veterinarian.
Oh my. Yeah. Then he needs to see Rouser immediately, as soon as possible.
Yes,
this poor doggy's in a daze.
I hope it's not the dreaded dog days of summer.
Why don't you two take Rouser upstairs for a rest, and I'll let you know immediately when Dr. Ray Bees and Nurse Kitty Litter return.
And where do we find our room?
Oh, your room is up the stairs and to the left.
Thank you.
Have
a nice rest.
Yeah. Well, I was only around Dr. Ray Bees and Nurse Kitty Litter for just a few moments, but I'm sure they're capable people who love their profession.
Well, I guess there's not much we can do till they get back then, right?
Yeah.
I guess I could go get the bath water ready for the snake here.
Yeah.
You know, Hugh, he really seems to like this guy. I think we should name him Pug.
What a beautiful name!
I thought so.
Yeah, okay, Doug. I want you to stay here with Polly. You can get a hold of the behaviors. I'll put your hand around.
I'll go get some bath crystals to soften your skin, Hugs. Now you stay right here and don't move a muscle.
Anyway, while we were on our stroll, we noticed a charming little puppy being carried from the stagecoach.
Oh, well, that's no ordinary dog. Let me tell you, it's a Rouser, the amazing Schnauzer.
Ta-da!
She's here with the Gray sisters.
Oh, what brings all of them to Wolf Creek?
A stagecoach. Oh.
No. Why are they here?
They were originally going to Buffalo Bill's Wild West show and, oh no, I don't know if I can say it. It's so horrible.
Well, I, just spit it out.
The dog went into a state of shock.
I thought this was the state of Idaho.
Don't mind her. You're telling me that the dog is here in this hotel?
Yes, and oh, she's just barking out for your professional assistance.
Oh, well, I suppose I could take a look at her.
Oh, that is just what I was hoping you would say. Oh, Patty, Ida, Rouser, hurry on down. Oh, I am so glad you two are here.
Oh, me too.
Yes, what is it?
I would like to introduce you three to Dr. Babies.
He bites!
Our veterinarian. And his capable assistant, Nurse Kitty Litter.
How do you do? I'm Ida Gree.
And I'm Patty Gree.
And this is Browser, the amazing Schnauzer. And we, of course, are the Gree sisters. Ta-da!
Oh, well, it's lovely to meet you all.
What in the world is this thing doing in my room? Not only does she make me sneeze, but she started chewing on my favorite body.
Can you all keep quiet out here?
But why are the animals so quiet, Grandma?
They're taking their afternoon nap.
Oh.
I think they fell asleep while getting the bathwater ready for hugs.
Oh, yeah.
It must have been the gentle sound of the water out back while he was pumping it.
But why didn't you go back to Farmer McDonald?
I was about to. While I was getting water for my horse, I saw Grandma Naya came out. And I just couldn't let her do all of the work preparing the snake's bath.
We decided to name your snake Hugs.
That's a fine name, Polly. You know, I always let you name the animals I bring by here. You're going to bathe the dead snake? Watch what you say. You may hurt his feelings. What? You mean the snake's actually alive?
Yeah, of course.
Where'd you find it? The cave out back. A cave? Say, does anyone have a claim to the land in the back?
Yes, it's our land. And we were going to build a playground there for all the little animals, yeah.
Miss Harmony! If you can carry a dog, you can carry your own hat.
Well, if you won't carry these boxes, then you can hold this thing.
Yeah. Oh.
I'll take her off your hands.
K-9? Miss K-9?
Uh-oh. What?
I must now hand over this eviction notice.
Boo!
Stagecoach ready for to go tomorrow. You people are weird.
What, may I ask, is going on?
Well, sir, I must foreclose on Miss Nine and Paul. They have not been paying their mortgage.
Oh, no.
Your time is up. I can wait no longer. You and your animals must leave in 3 days.
3 days?
I've never met a man with such accent and articulation and a passion for hats. My heart goes out to that lonely man.
Say, if I was to help these kind people raise the money, would you consider not foreclosing?
Well...
Oh, please, sir.
Yes, because we can't travel with a grouser in this ailing state.
And she needs love and care. We fear that the stage travel will be too rough on her.
Too hard for her.
Well, I don't know.
Well, I'd agree.
Yes?
What could you do? I am a man of integrity. I not only help people, but animals. Other way around. I not only help animals, but people. But when I say people, I mean me, myself, and I. There's some things out him that I don't trust.
Yeah.
But he may be able to help. As a qualified veterinarian, I can make this dog heal!
Hooray!
I even have a miraculous remedy to battle fleas!
Oh my, it's like a voice from heaven!
Don't trust him!
He means trust him!
Don't trust him!
I can even loan K9 the money needed to pay off the mortgage!
Now, how do you propose to achieve that outcome?
By setting up my own practice. I know the perfect spot.
Where?
Here.
Here?
Give me another room for my examination room. We will not only pay you a small rent, but also help you raise the money to pay off the mortgage. For a small interest, of course.
I've already given you two rooms, but you still need an examination room.
Oh, this is an outrage! You mean I not only have to sleep with a dog, but I'll have to share my room with a veterinarian?
Who said share?
Oh, Miss Harmony, it's all right. There's always the stay, the room clause out back. Well, that too, but it's small, but always clean. In fact, we kept the fleas out of it.
Yeah.
Nurse Kitty Litter, would you please share a room with my dog? Darn it!
She seems awfully pushy. But I better not ruffle her feathers by putting them in her place. Yes.
Please.
Of course.
Don't worry, dear. Everything will be just fine.
Yeah, of course it'll be fine.
Excuse me. It's your job to take care of the animals. It's my job to take care of Polly. Take care of him!
Oh, God.
I expect respect, or I'm gonna have
Please, Hugh. The hours are few, and we're in deep doggy do. I am terribly embarrassed. I sincerely apologize for the offensive language. He didn't mean anything by what he said. I just hope that Hugh meant everything he said. Please.
I guess I'm sorry. Sort of.
Please.
Fine. Apology accepted.
That's good.
Well then, Dr. Rabies, let me be the first to welcome you to Wolf Creek.
It's settled. I'm ready for my Wolf Creek veterinary practice. Just wait till they see what I have in store for them.
Is going to enter